Forgives us for our sin, and we continue to ask for God's mercy. And so we pray, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us, for you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. And so we pray. O God, show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path. Give all who for the faith they profess are accounted Christians the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ and to strive after all that is done in its honor. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus said the Lord, rejoice heartily, O daughter Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you. A just savior is he. Meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The warriors bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My King and
Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give you life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and I am humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Have you ever taken anything for granted? Have you ever taken anything in your life for granted? I know that I have taken things in my life for granted, and as a matter of fact, I took air conditioning were granted most recently. And at the rectory at St. Mary's, I plugged in a couple different air conditioners, and they all died. Everything died. All the lights, all the electricity. I was going to go to your house, Joe. Would Mary, she be okay with that?
Yep.
So it all died. So I know that my dad, if I learned anything from my dad, he'd say, go downstairs and check the breakers. So I checked the breakers and it all went back on, thank goodness. But I took for granted that ability to be cool, right? I took for granted that that sense that air conditioning would always be there. And if you've been anywhere outside over the past several days, you know how warm it is, how humid it is, and how nice it is to be in the house with air conditioning. Be in the house that's cool. I want to offer that because I think that there was a time in my life when I took something else for granted. When I was in seminary, one of my jobs that was assigned to me was to help teach driving to the seminarians that were from China, so Chinese seminarians. I know that sounds laughable. And one of the individuals that I had to teach driving to, his name was Peter Chen. Peter was from Shanghai in China, and I knew more about driving than he did, which certainly says a lot. And so I tried to teach him driving, and after we were finished, I went to the rector and I said, you know, I think he's going to do okay. I think he's going to be fine. He knows a little bit about driving, and he knows about really what he shouldn't do from my example. And I said to the rector, I said, you know, why is it that you asked me to teach him how to drive? And he said, I figured at the end of it, either he would know how to drive or he would know how to pray better. And so I think that was probably the motivation. But Peter always struck me as someone who was appreciative of where he was, and he understood all that was at stake. You know, we see a lot in the news today about China. And I think on this, our weekend, where we celebrate our independence, it's important for us not to take for granted our religious liberties. In talking to Peter, Peter would say that there are two churches in China. There's the state church and there's the underground church. And that celebrating the Eucharist from the underground church's perspective is in many ways very dangerous. And the government officials constantly are looking to shut those experiences down. Anything that has to do with the underground church is an experience that the government does not want to continue or partake in. In our lives, I think we have become more mindful of the Eucharist over these past several months and the ability to celebrate our faith. So I would ask us today to be mindful of that. I ask us to be mindful of this great gift of religious liberty that our country guarantees, and that we never want to take that for granted. And that in the spirit of the gospel, I ask all of us to be mindful of this prayer. And so we pray, God, help me to learn that true wisdom rests not in any secular metric, but in the knowledge and the wisdom that you sent your only Son into this world to save us. The Eucharist then becomes historical, perspective, motivational, and grounding. It is a grace for all ages, and in this country it is part of how we celebrate our religious liberty. We give thanks for both. And so we stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Mindful that our God hears the prayers of his people, we place our petitions before him.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that who have died with Christ in baptism may live for God in our families, our workplaces, and society, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, that God will guide us in living the values which we proclaim so that all may experience life, liberty, and justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For legislators and government leaders, that they will recognize needs of the poor and homeless and work to provide new options for safe housing and health care, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace and hospitality that we may welcome all whom God sends to us and receive them in generosity and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, that the Spirit of Christ may renew the gift of life within them and bring healing to their mind, body, and spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in a special way this week, we remember the following: John Thomas, Lisa Bendo Black, Aggie Iancello, David Haw, Nancy Barrett, and as well as the recently deceased. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for those intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. For these, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gathering all our prayers into one, we lift them up through Christ our Lord. Acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of the church, Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father, most holy, your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." Our mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may all be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout our world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, and all the clergy, our religious, and indeed all people everywhere. Remember also our brothers and sisters, those who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Mary, the Mother of God, the blessed Apostles, St. Mary Ann Cope, St. Augustine, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. And grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Love of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Shall be healed. And my burden
Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you in my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
On this weekend where we celebrate our independence as a country, we take a moment to pray together a Hail Mary for all those who have served our country and continue to serve our country in gratitude for their service. And so we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, having consumed these gifts, we pray that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may continue to grow. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Glory be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God continue to bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go in peace and love to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks, everybody. Thanks, Joe. Thanks, Brian. Thank you.